Hey scientists, today we're going to take a look at some different habitats on Earth and compare them to see how the habitats really influence the different plants and animals you would find there. Okay, so the four habitats we're going to look at today are the Arctic, kelp forests in the ocean, regular forests on land, and then the desert. And each one of these habitats are very unique, and so are the plants and animals that you would find there. All right, so let's get going. So first up, we have the Arctic. Now it is very, very cold in the Arctic, and you can find water everywhere. Okay, a lot of the water is fresh water, which is in the form of snow, glaciers, which is mostly ice, the icebergs, which break off from the glaciers into the ocean. But then the ocean and the sea ice in the ocean is made of salt water. Okay, and all of the animals that live in the Arctic need to be adapted to handle this very, very cold environment. Because it is so cold year-round, you will find very few plants in the Arctic. They tend to be in the form of mosses, grass, and small shrubs. As for animals, many of the mammals you would find on land have thick white fur to help them camouflage and to stay warm. This would include the polar bear, the Arctic fox, and the Arctic hare, as an example. Animals you would find in the cold ocean of the Arctic need many layers of fat to keep them warm and help them go long periods of time with little food. These include seals, walruses, and orcas. Alright, next up we have kelp forests. Now, kelp forests are found in the shallow ocean waters near coastlines. The water there isn't as cold as the Arctic, and the ecosystem really revolves around the kelp. Kelp are large brown seaweeds that anchor to the ocean floor, and they grow towards the ocean surface. The animals you would find in the kelp forests are adapted to live in salt water all the time. These animals include sea otters, which are some of nature's cutest animals by far, many types of fish, including kelpfish and Garibaldi, and some creatures that live on the seabed, like sea urchins and abalone. Many of the animals in the kelp forests eat the kelp, or they eat the animals that feed on the kelp. Alright, so next up we're going to move on to forests and rainforests. Alright, now forests have a lot of water and rainfall, which is why trees and plants, which really depend on water, thrive there. So even in the winter, if it's really cold, and it turns to snow and ice, that snow and ice will eventually melt and will replenish the trees and the rivers that you'd find there. And with all the trees and diversity of plants there, there's a lot of different foods for animals to eat, and there's also a lot of shelter for animals as well. So it really breeds a very diverse group of animals in the forest. Depending on where you are on Earth, these animals can include mammals such as pandas, chimpanzees, jaguars, and deer, birds such as parrots or woodpeckers, and insects such as spiders, beetles, or millipedes. You can also find many decomposers in the forest, which include fungi, invertebrates, and microscopic bacteria. These decomposers help to decompose all the dead trees, leaves, and animals that fall to the forest floor, and they replenish the soil to help with new growth. Decomposition also requires a lot of water, so the forest is well suited for this whole process. Okay, so the last habitat we're going to talk about today are deserts. Now, deserts are very hot and arid, which means that there's very little water there and it's very dry. So unlike forests, it barely ever rains or snows in the desert. So because of this, the animals that live there really need to be adapted to the heat and the lack of water. Many of the plants in the desert, like the cactus, are succulents. Succulents are very good at retaining water. This way, when it does rain, they hold on to that water for a long, long time in order to survive. Animals you would find in the desert are well suited to this environment as well, and often have furs or exteriors that will blend in with the brown, dry landscape and help with camouflage. Some of these animals include camels, coyotes, snakes, lizards, and jackrabbits. So now we've only looked at four habitats on Earth, and there are many, many more. But this is just to show you that the habitats on Earth are very diverse, and depending on the type of habitat, it will really shape the plants and animals that exist there. Because these plants and animals over many, many years have really adapted to thrive in these different environments. And so I really thank you for joining us today, and I will see you next time.
Okay, scientists, thanks for watching. Did you enjoy that lesson? Subscribe below to see more fun science videos. You can also become a member of PS Science on Patreon to support what we're doing. See you next time.